There's been so much response to my recent video, Economic Collapse in 2011, that I've decided to produce another video called Economic Apocalypse and go over some of the same basic features and see if I can clarify even more for you what's going on. If you're viewing this video, you probably already know that we're heading to an economic apocalypse, but what you don't know is perhaps how soon it's going to occur. And my advice to you is to put all your attention into non-dual realization at this time. And I know there are plenty of people out there saying, you know, buy survivalists, buy gold, silver, etc., etc. That's not my advice. My advice is put all your attention and efforts into non-dual realization. Now, as far as the timeline goes, the point of no return was reached in 1999, in August of 1999. From that point on, all of this unraveling was a fait accompli. In fact, it's always been a fait accompli, really. It's just at that point that the gears really began to go in motion, and you know very well what's happened since that time. Now, 2011 was actually a foreshadowing of what's going to happen. If you look at the World Trade Centers, they symbolized world financial structure, okay, the massive structure that has been constructed in this planet. And what you saw was an unbelievably rapid collapse of those structures. And that's a foreshadowing of what's going to happen later in 2011. We've seen a rise in destructivity in the world of all sorts of natural disasters, earthquakes, tornadoes, hurricanes, tsunamis, you name it. But those are just also precursors of what's to come. It's a package deal, you know. It's not just the economy that's going to collapse. It's an overall destructive phase that we're in right now. But from the non-dual perspective, this is just business as usual. This is just existence being existence. And that's why people are able to warn others about it. Those who have been around the block quite a bit, they realize that existence is dualistic. It's a one dynamic of constructivity and destructivity. It's one dance, okay? Two dance partners, but one dance, destructivity and constructivity. They cannot be separated. They're part of a dualistic dynamic. And constructivity is built up, and then destructivity comes in. Now, on November 2010, the pure intent for destructivity was released into the world. At that time, I posted some videos specifically saying that in late January of 2011, events would begin to unfold, the collapse would begin to be seen, the writing would begin to be seen very strongly. And of course, that turned out to be very accurate, because that's when the flare-ups in North Africa and the Middle East began to take place, and then followed, of course, by the terrible March tsunami in Japan. Now, what I'm saying is that the second half of 2011 is when the collapse is really going to take place. I'm saying that the writing is going to be on the wall in July, this month, July. It's going to become very evident. For those of you who are paying attention, you realize you can read the writing and you're saying, uh-oh. We are in a downward spiral. It's like there's a fire in the top of the World Trade Center and people are saying, uh-oh. But they don't realize that it's suddenly going to pancake the whole thing. Now, was the pancaking helped out? Well, quite possible, right? I'm not going to say one way or the other, but either way you look at it is okay with me. But I'll tell you this, that the collapse of the world financial structure is 100% intentional. It's completely booby-trapped. It has been set up and rigged in a very, very clever way by extraordinarily clever agents of destructivity, and not judging them, it's part of the dance of existence. But they've set it up in a foolproof way, and it cannot be stopped. And it can happen very quickly, like a flash crash. Now, the world is going to be left in a stunned condition. Very, and like paralyzed, and not knowing what to do, financially speaking, because it seems like the rug will have been pulled out from under everyone. And the opportunity will be there for you to wake up to your options and realize you do have an option that you haven't seen before, which is to actually choose a different idea, another idea. Existence is actually based on one idea. You have the capacity to choose another idea. Now, I'm telling you that the way to respond to this situation is turn to non-dual realization. And if you're not getting what you want here, I suggest you go to Muji, M-O-O-J-I. Look up Muji. He's a terrific non-dual teacher. My approach is different than his, but he's tremendous. Now, I came into the world to pioneer a new approach to non-dual realization. And its focus is telling you that the real salvation from the dance of duality existence is to choose a new idea. Okay, that's my approach. And I believe that's the clearest approach. My approach is somewhat dry, but you know, in a very dry area, when the atmosphere is very dry, you can see the farthest, can't you? It's the clearest atmosphere there is. Where there's a lot of humidity, it's not so clear, a lot of distortion. So I like the very dry approach, very clear approach. And I'll post a lot of videos going over this approach and showing you just how, you know, clear it really is, what your options really are. You need to assess your options. I mean, start right now. Don't wait until the flash crash happens, because you're going to be stunned at that time. At least hearing this now, you realize, okay, something's going to happen. Your expectations begin to be clarified, so you won't be completely stunned. But at the same time, I'm saying put your focus on non-dual realization. Even if you don't know what that is, go listen to Muji, for instance, and you'll start getting a feel for the flavor of it. Or you can listen to the videos here, get a feel for the fact that there you do have an option. Now, this economic apocalypse is really going to take place. It's been pre-planned for a long time. It's part of the dance of destructivity. That's what destructivity does, and destructivity knows its business very, very well. And in order to understand what I'm talking about, you need to set aside your naivete and thinking that the good always wins. No, it doesn't. It does not. The good always succumbs. Constructivity always succumbs to destructivity, and yet it survives to produce more constructivity. The reason I'm able to explain all of this is because I'm not so naive. I set that aside. You must set your naivete aside. I've been able to foresee many, many things in my life accurately about the future, simply because I could see it. I was not invested in naivete, saying that the good always prevails. The constructivity is just going to continue unabated. I said, no, that's not how the universe works. That's not how existence works. That's not the dynamic that's dancing at play. The business of existence is ceaseless constructivity and destructivity. Okay, that's what really takes place. So you have these bubbles, you know, like the dot-com bubble. I told everybody, I said, this is going to collapse. It's based on nothing. And it did. And then in 2008, I said, you know what, economic collapse is coming. This is the beginning of it, and it's not going to get better. It's going to get worse and worse and worse. And of course it has. But I'd say that was only a precursor to this flash crash economic apocalypse, which is set to take place in the second half of 2011. It may be as late as November. I'm not exactly sure. But sometime in this time frame, the flash crash is going to happen. Now, you know, when someone checks into a hospital and the reports come out, the doctors say, well, he's in, you know, critical condition, but they won't say anything more. You don't really know what's going on. Sometimes the patient gets well. Other times the patient succumbs. But the doctors, they don't really tell you exactly what's going on. Same thing, the governments and media will not tell you exactly what's going on. They may not even know themselves. I'm telling you, the booby trapping of this economy is done on a very clever, subtle level, beyond the reach of any governments, okay? This is done by architects of destruction, who know their business extremely well and can carry it out, and they don't need any help from any governments. But by the same token, the government is like a doctor, and they know the patient's sick, but they're not going to tell you, well, the patient is terminal. They're not going to say that. You know, they can say, well, things don't look really good, you know, and they have been saying that. Things are looking very poor, and, well, little improvement, or things are holding steady, you know, still critical condition, but it's, you know, well, bad signs here, you know, and, but you know the patient is very, very, very ill, and at any time, things could go in the wrong direction, and they most certainly will. When they get the right push, and they will be pushed, the collapse will happen. And the best thing for you is to maintain your sense of humor, maintain your perspective, listen to non-dual teaching, satsang, and begin to clarify for yourself what your situation really is, and that realize that you're in this hypothetical scenario of plausibility. That's what existence really is. It's not actual at all. It's like a dream. It's the effects of an idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality. But that's just an idea that Spirit chose, and Spirit can choose another idea. What you really are is Spirit. You're not a person. You're not a persona. You're Spirit. And you chose the idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality. And what happened was this hypothetical scenario of plausibility began dancing in front of you. And you've been paying attention to this dance for so long. And you're waiting for an outcome of this dance. But the fact is, there is no final outcome at all. It's all futility. It's a waste of your time. Nothing happens. Nothing's ever happened. Reality is completely untouched by this dance of duality. Doesn't touch it at all. Never has. Never will. So the only way out is to decide to choose another idea. Spirit says, well, this is futile and I'm tired of it, so I'm going to choose the idea of not trying to replace reality. And that gives a continuity, because you can still see all the attempts, the dance that's going on, but now what you have is a feeling of seamlessness that's unaffected by the dance. No matter what the dance is doing, it doesn't affect the seamless feeling at all. And that's the peace beyond understanding. And that's an option that you have. In fact, that's the only option you really have. No matter what happens in existence, that option is always there, always will be there, and it's the only actual option that you have, is to choose a new idea. Now, when the economic apocalypse occurs, don't play the blame game. And I'll help you with that. It's crucial. Don't get pulled into it at all. Okay? Just realize that, you know, this was all foreseen. The pure dust destructivity is now has full reign on this planet to play as it wants to play. And that's part of the cosmic dance of existence. It's all been foreseen. It can't be stopped. Yet you always have the capacity to choose a new idea. Now, I'm not giving any advice as to what someone should do financially at all. My advice is to spend your time focusing on non-dual realization, because that's what's truly going to make the difference as you assess your options going forward. And the best option to take is a destiny path that heightens your capacity towards non-dual realization, non-dual clarification, so that ultimately you finally choose a new idea. That's the ultimate goal. But taking a destiny path that enables you to get there is absolutely crucial. That's the correct response to this economic apocalypse flash crash in the second half of 2011. Okay. Appreciate your patience in listening to this. Thank you. See you next time.